Welcome to another episode here on Hungry for Returns, where I answer your trading and investing questions. If you have questions, be sure to submit them. You can write in at tradersfly.com or even submit them through voice and audio, and you might be featured on the show. So today's question is all about dividend cuts. So let's go to the screen and take a look at the question. So the person writes, "Hey Sasha, I'm new to investing and had a simple dividend question. When a company cuts its dividend, who does it affect? Is the dividend cut to new people buying the stock, or does it cut the dividend of previous stock owners too? So for example, I buy McDonald's at 165 with a dividend of 2.78%, which would be the rate I would be somewhat locked in on. Then the company cuts the dividend. Does it affect my 2.78%, or will the cut only affect new buyers? I hope you can understand what I'm asking. I'm struggling to figure this out. Thank you so much, Jason." So it's an interesting question because, you know, when we think about prices overall, let's just say, hey, we go to the store, we get a price, and then you could take a rain check and you're kind of locked into the price. Also, let's say, hey, you buy a subscription on Netflix, you buy a subscription for your TV, whatever the case may be on the internet, you're kind of locked into the rate that you buy, right? So you would think that, hey, I'm also locked in if I'm at 2.78% with McDonald's. Wouldn't I also be locked into the dividend there as well if they cut the dividend? The thing with this is no, you're not locked in because the dividend gets changed time and time again. And in fact, most of the time with good, healthy stocks, the dividend continues to actually increase. Here, as we take a look, let's go take a look at McDonald's just so we can use this example here. The dividend yield here you can see is 2.78%, right? So your annual payout is about 4.64. It's been paying out for 41 years. The dividend has been growing. So if you look at the chart overall, the dividend has been steadily growing with time. And if you really look at it, here is our dividend on the NASDAQ, the cash amount. So here we have 1.16 on 11/30/2018 that is set to be paid out. And here we have 1.01 on 8/31/2018 that was set to pay out. And let's just say of last year you were at 94 cents. So with time, that dividend actually continues to grow. And take a look, let's say in 2013, you were at 77 cents. So really, in general, it's a good thing that your dividend is always being adjusted because most of the time, healthy, good quality stocks, the dividend grows. Unfortunately, yes, sometimes this dividend gets cut. So let's say this 1.01 got cut in half, then it would affect you as a stockholder, the previous stockholders, and any new people as well that are buying into it. So it would affect everybody. Doesn't matter if you bought the stock 100 years ago, 50 years ago, everybody gets affected on the cut. Everybody gets affected on the raise. Doesn't matter when you bought it, it's everybody. So when they change the dividend rate, when they change the dividend amount, you will get affected regardless of if you had the stock or if you didn't have the stock in the past. If you're looking to buy the stock in the future, that would be the new rate. So it's basically changed for everybody depending on, you know, how many shares you hold, then that's how many, how much dividends you'll receive. But overall, you know, most of these stocks, they do continue to appreciate with time and the dividend continues to increase. But if there's a cut, then you get affected, whether you held it in the past or you're looking to buy new shares. And if there's an increase, you also benefit from that as well. So as you can see from here, you know, it's not that these people in 2013 are locked in at 77 cents for the dividend. They're now at the $1.16 as well. So anyways, I hope this makes sense to this question. So if you're asking, you know, who does it affect? It affects everybody. New people buying the stock, and it affects old people with you know, previous stock owners as well. So it affects everybody. I hope that makes sense to clarify that question a bit. All right, so thank you so much for joining me. If you have questions that you want answered about trading and investing, or just some different opinion, then be sure to ask your question by going to this link right over here. You can go ahead and submit one by form or even submit one by voice. Thanks for joining me. And in the end, remember, do what you love, contribute to other people, but most importantly, live life abundantly. I'll see you next time.